in the ice block. The mass spell comes in. Alice all along. Fear DR still available.
Flappers has no trigger. Relsa managed to premonition the repentance and avoid it. Great play from him. This could allow them to be greedy, but I don't.
Yeah, Method Black dancing circles around Tempo Storm right now. Cheap shot into the smoke bomb on Alex. Lights Rat's gonna connect as well. Alex manages to survive as Minpoike is able to connect some heals, but there's the full kidney shot of Minpoike. A little bit of pressure on Raikou. The full Ring of Frost onto Chaz. Both mages could be in some trouble here, but Alec definitely far behind with only having one ice block available.
Oh, look at Waz.
Looking for the follow-up onto Chaz. Manages to find it. Waz reconnecting onto Alec, though. Both mages, like I said, in a little bit of trouble as both priests get out of crowd control.
Full blind, no trinket, full stun, you're done. Chaz with the mass dispel. Everybody in crowd control. Method Black at the pinnacle of skill as Alec hangs on by a thread. Minpoike fears away Waz. He buys him a second. He buys him another, but it's not good. Might be enough. He's hanging at 10%. Minpoike doing anything. He did it. He stayed alive. But they're so far behind. What can they really do? Are they actually going to go after Waz? Waz doesn't really have anything. Pain suppression's going to stabilize it for a couple more seconds. Alec now in the back foot, though. As Minpoike gets caught into a full poly. Chaz brings the blind. Waz should recover. Alec on the run. Waz is the only opening. But Alec locked down in the sun. It's going to ultimately get closed out. He gets purged on it. They swap to Nyxie with no trinket. Minpoike leaves the stun, but Nyxie's in so much trouble. The smoke bomb gets dropped. He's out of line of sight. He barely stays alive. Minpoike manages to pull through and somehow keep this together.
Yeah, kitty shot on Chaz. Now setup going on to Raikou, but it doesn't unfortunately land on Chaz. He uses actually the human racial, so he doesn't get caught into that Ring of Frost. Now full fear onto Chaz. Can they find the damage on Raikou? Doesn't look like it. Raikou's doing a good job with his Icy Veins, just spamming out the Polymorphs on a Nyxie. Nyxie really just hasn't been able to connect at all. Now it's Method Black's turn to go. Kidney shot over on him in Poike, into the full fear, under the full ring. And Alec in the ice block, the mass spell comes in. Alec all alone, fear DR still available.
Look at that timing.
He's looking for that mass dispel onto Raikou, but Chaz deflects it with a nicely timed mind control. Raikou can easily walk out of the room now. Now we're back to the standard opener that we talked about with Zico, where both mages are in stealth. Sap on Minpoike, sap on Chaz. This is looking like an exact mirror so far.
All right, and Alec is using Temp Shield, whereas Raikou is not. It doesn't seem like Nyxie is having a great time connecting, and Method Black have taken complete control of this starting aggression with Minpoike locked into a Polymorph now. Alec could easily have to ice block. Chaz lands the Psychic Scream. There's an ice block, there's a Mass Dispel. Alec's out of it. Minpoike is still feared up. It's match point, and Alec falls. Method Black are unstoppable.
Needs to be careful. This could be a dispersion. It's a race. Dizio dipping low as well. Dispersion gets traded out. Ratify leaving that trap. If they can land another Repentance, they could secure the aspect of the turtle or a kill. Ratify still locked down. He's going to be marching towards Rels, I can imagine, shortly. Avenging Wrath should allow Valai to easily stabilize as he jumps into Void Form. But a huge ferocious bite connects. Another huge heal counteracts it from Ratify. Valai getting stunned up. Rels are trying to dispel dots. Bustian protection on Valai to get him aggressive on top of him. He gets knocked away from the
scream.
Great play from Dizio. Ratify gets countershot. Dizio, defensive MV play right here. But Ratify now gets bursting shot on the Repentance. They need to delay the Repentance as long as possible to secure a trap. This could be a trinket, likely. I almost would much rather see him trinket, sack, and go for a Repentance and try and end the game. Now, Ratify is just falling behind. He's going to trinket and sack. Look for the Repentance again. He lands it. Dizio feign deaths all the dots off. Valai reapplies it. They're going after Flappers. Flappers has no trinket. Relsa managed to premonition the Repentance and avoid it. Great play from him. This could allow them to be greedy, but I don't think so.
Oh!
That was a ton of damage out of nowhere.
Matchup as well. That's why we saw him go so fast. It also allows him to top off his team very quickly out of crowd control.
So pain suppression used preemptively. Relsa loves to use those cooldowns to get his team aggressive. That will allow Dizio to sit through that full stun lock basically for free. Maro now trying to blink away as Ratify's caught in crowd control. Temp shield activated, but they haven't done any damage into it. Now waiting for it to end. Flappers pops the incarnation. Dizio disengages right on top of Maro. That's going to be a lot of damage. That's going to be a first block forced out. And on this map, Reformed looks so much better in the matchup. Akros trying to find some counter pressure. He's got Shadow Blades up. He's looking to pull that Shadow Dance. Relsa getting counterspelled. He's going to kidney shot. Look for a poly. They get the poly. Dizio's far away, though. He could kite. He gets rooted by the flurry and gets caught into a cheap shot. Just gets deleted instantly from the arena. He blinks in. He lands it. There's going to be a ton of damage. He pops Icy Veins. He's holding onto it. He's trying to bait more cooldowns. He gets a trinket. Survival Instincts before the smoke bomb. He might even just die through it. I almost wonder if he did Icy Veins that Flappers would have died right there. He might still die ultimately as the smoke bomb gets dropped. Jumps out of it 1 second before it landed, and I think Akro got a little bit ahead of himself there. If he had been patient, went for that smoke bomb later on, Flappers had no way to get out of it.
Yeah, Maro still had the Icy Veins as well, so I think that patience would have definitely paid off. Maro now having to play a little bit defensive here with the bash onto Ratapai. Dizio bursting shot onto Ratapai, followed up most likely by the trap. There it is. Maru all by himself. Ratapai trinkets out to keep him alive. Still has the Rapture and paints up available. But Flappers and Dizio both could be in potential trouble here if Relza gets caught in any more crowd control.
All right, Flapper's trying to get a second block here. Ratapai not crowd controlled, though. There's a counter shot onto the heel. Maru fully shielded up, though. He should be quite tanky. There's the stun. Dizio needs to land the trap, but they set up for the kill onto Flappers. If they had a smoke bomb here, but they don't even need it. Full polymorph secured. I don't know how Flappers are going to make it out alive. Bear form might not be enough. He charges over, but they got no interrupt for the poly, and Flappers will fall. Ascendant advance 3-1. Members early getting counterspelled. Crota dipping low, trades out the anti-magic shield. Byla now in a position with no cooldowns. He's just going to gun for a kill with the double stun, double trinket overlap from Tempo Storm. Now that's an opening potentially for Windwalker DK Nation to abuse moving forward.
Yeah, that was a touch of death. Serenity still going to be available for Balia, but a hex over onto Burly. Crota gets lower. Spirit Link Totem is forced out as well as the AMZ, so big overlap there for Windwalker DK Nation, but honestly can't blame them. That was such a scary moment. Now Crota once again trying to find his target, trying to get onto that Ride the Wind so he can get rid of those snares and get back onto this pesky Arcane Mage. Poike playing very far away, so they can't get the drip double stuns. Balia and Crota rotting down. Jamie's been doing a good job creating pressure, and Balia, with no touch of karma, gets caught.
He's going to bash it, but now he's walked into a Windwalker Death Knight. He's trying to retreat away from that stack. Crota caught into a stun with no trinket. Burly's got a lot of work ahead of him. He's trying to get the healing waves. He gets kicked by Nixie, and Nixie has been on fire this game with control. The kick into the clone, and Crota's hanging on by a thread. Deathstrike after Deathstrike to stay alive. Anti-magic zone buys him another Deathstrike. Burly is still crowd controlled as Crota is clinging onto life. Burly now into a stun. The anti-magic zone is fading as Tempo Storm leads the charge.
Leading the series 2-0.
Both of the melee off of Minpoike by placing that on the bottom. Sick positioning from Minpoike. One of the best druids in Europe showcasing it there. Just defusing a situation that might have been his end, but ultimately getting caught. And Crota's riding the wind over. Barskin might not be enough. If Burly can get the purges in, they need to take him down. Silence denies the displacer beats. He's on 10%. He goes for the Typhoon, but they're still DR'd from the Vortex. Minpoike blinks down. He gets paralysis. Crota's going to reconnect. Burly jumps in. Minpoike's got nothing left. He gouges Burly to deny the purges. If he gets any purges, Minpoike is going to fall. They stun up Crota. They look for the counter kill. Minpoike is on 10%, but Crota could fall as well. Pistol Fury, trinkets up.
Pretty high.
And yeah, I think that is a very, very likely scenario to happen for our next game. Probably Mage Ellie, Tolveron Arena, max range. But I'm not entirely sure, actually. They could. Is Ashaman still open? I think it is, right?
Yep.
They could still also pick Ashaman.
Tag onto that Ride the Wind if he wants to. He's just choosing to take it slow. He doesn't want any help from his team. And Poike gets stunned out of form. Crota pulls the trigger. Wraithwalk immediately onto target. They're going to race against the Barkskin. This is, I think, a mistake by Minpoike to not trinket, getting stunned out of form. They could potentially all in him if Burly spams out the purges. Minpoike needs to create distance. He gets gripped into a blind. He can easily displace her beast away from this now, though. Should be able to get to safety. Displaces across the map, but he had to use trinket, Barkskin, and Iron Bark. And Windwalker DK Nation, they are not letting off the gas pedal. Ride the Wind, Touch of Death, Fist of Fury. Byla wants to put Minpoike in the ground, and this is easily going to be the end of the game. Touch of Death explodes. Minpoike gets destroyed, and we're going to game
now
five.
He's gonna have to be careful,
or maybe not. Maybe the best thing is to just run at Minpoike and pray that he dies. I mean, it's match point against Tempo Storm, and you're Windwalker DK Nation. You're just praying on a miracle to take him down. Iron Bark Frenzy Regen. Minpoike recovers. Anti-magic zone before the stun. Preemptive play from Crota. Minpoike getting caught into the stun, but he is in bear form. You should easily take this out with peels from Nixie. Nixie doing a great job to stall this game as long as possible. Poike tossing in Cenarian Ward, displacing back behind the pillar, line of sighting the death grip, but Frodo Wraith walks over. Burly's on top of him. Barkskin's the last line, but if they can purge him down, they can easily all in him still. Buddha Totem, stun, triple crowd control. Burly's still just going at him. They have to take him down. They might be able to do it, Ben.
Yeah, I mean, Poike is in so much trouble, still just line of sighting the best he can. Valiant ports over, gets the Fist of Fury stun. Burly needs to get in this line of sight to get off the defensive purges. And Poike now changing pillars, full blind on Balia. Can the silence still